Imagine climbing the steps up to the attic. You open a dusty trunk and stare at the treasures inside. You come back down, carrying a stack of VHS tapes and an old player in your arms. Amazingly, it all still works, and you pop in the first tape. As the image becomes clear, we see that we're watching the Russell Street Reunion of 1986. The Russell Street Reunion was an annual tradition that began in 1972 when former residents of Portsmouth's North End would meet to reminisce and socialize, catching up after years away from their beloved neighborhood. A neighborhood that was once home to a predominantly Italian-American population, though black residents and immigrants from other countries, including China, Sweden, Greece, and Poland, also made their homes here. In 1966, the City Council voted to approve an urban renewal project that would demolish the homes of nearly 300 families living in the city's North End. Along with houses, businesses, including restaurants, lumber yards, beauty shops, and corner stores, were also bulldozed as a result of these urban renewal efforts. This video was produced in 1986 by Dennis Robinson of Ideaworks and was one of his first independent assignments as he transitioned from teaching to founding his own creative services company. The film was taped and edited by Gould Productions and originated by Al DiStefano. The Vaughan Street Urban Renewal Project broke up the concentrated Italian district of the city. Residents moved to other neighborhoods or even left town, but many maintained connections with the other families that would last a lifetime.
But I guess the only regret that I could say I have now is that my children don't have any roots like we had in Russell Street and in Deer Street. And it's too bad, because you had a sense of belonging to that neighborhood. And if you walked down Russell Street or you walked down Deer Street, you knew that you belonged. And you knew that no matter what house you went to, you were going to be accepted for what you were. And that's the only thing I could say that I wish that my children had, and they're not going to have that, unfortunately.
I spent a lot of time in the North End, and one of the memories that I have is of scaring my godmother to death, almost to death, with a turtle, because she's so frightened of turtles. And I had a turtle, and I used to visit with it, and it got loose, and Jean never did know where that turtle was. And she got even with my parents, though, because she gave, one time for Christmas, gave me a drum, and I kept my parents awake, I think through New Year's, with that drum. So she got even in any event for my for my turtle act. It's wonderful that these kinds of reunions. We had one in the South End, which is Puddle Dock, where I'm from, and of course this one, Russell Street North End. And it's great to see that kind of neighborhood spirit still alive. And I hope that people who view this tape and people who are here can really learn something from it, something about being a neighbor, something about being close. It's really wonderful, and it was the North End was an absolutely beautiful neighborhood with some wonderful people there.
We were the Fiendakers. We lived next to the railroad track, and across from us were the Dorios, the DiStefanos, and the Caninos, and we're all quite close, and the place was, we had our own playground. We played in the street and made our own toys, playing kick the can and Peggy with a stick and a pointed peg. And we had our own swimming pool, which was across the tracks near Nobles Island. There was a, in the Piscataquis River. There was no tide there, and we all learned to swim and dive. And I have pictures here of the swimming hole and some of the houses.
We are the DiStefano family. My father, Ferdinand, came to America in 1907. He was 23 years old. He was born in Italy in a little village called San Giovanni in Gardago, between Rome and Naples. He worked hard and saved enough money to send for my mother, Victoria, to whom he was engaged. A year later, he bought a new home on 28 Russell Street, where we all grew up. There were five children in my family. My father worked for the Electric Light Company at the end of Bow Street. He was supervisor of that crew that provided the power for the generators, which is now named Harbor Place.
My father was typical of all the Italians that came over from Italy. And one of the things that struck me about 30 years later, when I got out from grammar school, I met an old school teacher. And I said to the school teacher, "We know why they send you young girls when you finish college down here to train for teaching, because if you could teach all us Italian kids, you could teach any place in the city." She started laughing and she said, "Do you know that if any of you kids acted up, all we had to say was, we shall discuss this with your father." That was the end of the problem.
Good old Russell Street, we had a lot of good times there, and they made the best of wines, and we had a lot of picnics, and they were a nice bunch of people. And it's too bad they done away with Little Italy there. We used to call Russell Street Little Italy. It's a real bunch of people. Now they've broken them up, and they've got nothing there.
My name is Diva Perini McDonald. I was born, brought up on Russell Street. First of all, I'd like to say how very, very proud I am of my heritage. My mom and dad came over from Italy, and I can remember so many stories that my dad used to tell me. We used to have so much fun on Russell Street, playing games, run, sheep, run, relevo, hide and seek, baseball, hoop the hoop, roller skating. We never had to leave our street for entertainment. The only time we left our street was to go to school, at the Farragut School, and then at home. I miss Russell Street. Even after I got married and moved off, I used to ride by every now and then, and so many memories would come back to me. How Sammy taught us how to dance in the alley. That was a time of the jitterbug. We used to wear out more shoes. And then I'd go home and I'd get the devil because my shoes were so dirty and the soles would be coming off. But it was a lot of fun.
I'm Fury Sackle, retired in Saugus, Massachusetts. And my brothers are all deceased. In order, they were Frank, John, James, Victor, Anthony, and Ernest. And I have two sisters, a retired nurse, Rose, in Plymouth, and a retired school teacher, Helen, in Wakefield, Mass. And she has got children and friends back here in town. Regretfully, she's not here this evening. And my mother's beautiful name was Philomena, 4'8" and very bright.
I don't have a mother's got to
My name is Jane Cumble Perini. I was born in Sicily. I came to this country in 1928, the age of eight. My mother and my father were here. My three sisters and my other sister Mary was born in 1928. I went to the Farragut School beautiful memories in that school. And I got married in 1940 to a Natale Perini, which they called him Tino for a nickname. I had two beautiful daughters, Delmira Perini and Geraldine Perini. I've always lived in Portsmouth and enjoyed it very much.
I'm a Mrs. Maldini. I came in this country in 1933. I've been here 53 years. I'm married to Giulio Maldini. He just passed away 2 months ago. I got two boys, Nat and Joe and Bianca, and a stepdaughter, Louise, and a husband, Charlie. And I've been very happy in this country. I love everybody. And people, they've been very good to me. And I got word to thank everybody because they've been good to me. Thank you. God bless America.
My name is Annie Adorio. It used to be Adorio, now I'm Annie Ritchie. I was born and raised on Russell Street. My parents were the second Italian family to move on Russell Street, so that's quite a few years ago. And I remember the house that we lived in, where two Irish families lived there. And when we bought them, they moved up the creek. So the saying was the Italians moved in the north end, and the Irish moved up the creek. And I remember during the Depression, when we lived near the railroad tracks, and we used to know the conductors and the engineers that went by. And during the Depression, they'd take and shovel coal out so that anybody that really needed would go and pick them up. And my mother was a midwife, and anybody that was had in those days, they had their children at home. And when they were getting ready to give birth, they'd all send for my mother. And she was highly respected. We had a little grocery store, and anybody that's here tonight will remember coming in there.
Well, I'm Azio Farini, and I had the privilege of living at 64 Deer Street all my early life. My parents came over from Italy just prior to World War I, and it was just marvelous growing up in a neighborhood where we may have been materially poor, but culturally rich in the strong neighborhood feelings that we had and the fine relationship we had with all our relatives and friends, a thing that has long disappeared now in this country. Hopefully it'll be returning to that.
My name is Rose Lamarca Pope, and I lived on Russell Street all my young life, and I had four brothers and three sisters. I remember mostly all us gathering in the summertime outside on the doorsteps and having a great time. And it's so wonderful to see them all after all these years.
I'm Harriet Lamarca. I'm the widow of Sam Lamarca. And his whole family lived on Russell Street. He was very, very proud of his family, of his background, of his whole town. And one of the things that really stands out in my mind is he had the first radio, and he always said that when the younger girls used to come in his house, open all the windows and turn on the radio and then go home and do their housework. So he was really proud of his neighborhood and of his Italian heritage, and I think it's just a wonderful thing.
My name is Delfo Caminati. I was born in Wall Street, just off Russell Street, in 1911, so I'm an old-timer. Down through the years, I've seen many changes, but I have very fond memories growing up as a child, not knowing the language and learning it when we first started going to school. I remember the old families, the Adorios and the Brighis and the Cavarettas and the Ravaglias and so many I can't recall. We were all very poor, but we had a great life, and it was enjoyable, and it's a great pleasure for me to be here tonight to renew old acquaintances, some of whom I've not seen for many, many years.
We represent Mr. Dominic Piola and family. In our family, there's about eight of us. My sister Teresa, my sister Ray, my sister Mary, Rose and Camilla, and my two brothers, Johnny, and Eddie, and my name is Jasper Paola. And this is on my right hand side is my sister Ray.
John Marcello.
John Marcello. And this is Gary, my sister's Rose son. And my father used to run a restaurant in Portsmouth for many years near the railroad station. His name was Dominic, and my mother's name was Philomena. And we had a happy life, and we're going to continue to do have a happy life.
Como esta, Portsmouth? My name is Joe DiStefano. I am the son of Albie and Jean DiStefano and the grandson of Fred and Victoria DiStefano from Russell Street. The folks that I remember the best growing up as a child in the North End was Kumbata Pep's Barbershop, was Babona's Tomato Garden, all of Russell Street, Wall Street, Green, all where the railroad tracks are now, used to be the old Boston and Main Railroad Station. It was a very good neighborhood to grow up in.
My name is Gene Francois, and I'm married to Mary Gallo, who's of the Gallo family. With me, I have my nephew, Bobby Gerasi, who is the son of Angie Gerasi, who is also a Gallo. And one of the reasons we agreed to speak here together is because we'd like to honor the memory of Bobby's father, Pepe Gerasi. Bobby, from the notes that your dad left, you know that your dad came here approximately the first part of the century. Could you tell us a little bit about your father?
Well, my father, his father's name was Ignazio, and his mother's name was Michelina. And his father came over here in about 1910 or 11 on his own, and he went to work for the railroads. He went down south. He made enough money, and then he brought his family over. And my father and his brother were the only two children born at that time.
Your brother, I mean your Uncle John.
My Uncle John. And when my Uncle John came over, he was 6 years old, and my father was 3 years old. And he said out of 14 children that they had, only four survived, which goes to show you something about the birth rate in those days. And they were all named after fathers, great-grandfathers, and etc.
My name is Mundo Zoffoli. I come from Russell Street, born on Deer Street, a family of eight. And when urban renewal came through and took our houses, they put us all in debt because they didn't pay us enough for the property. So my mother and father are from Italy, Satorcanzi di Romagna, Provincia di Forlì. My father was here in 1911, went back, served his time, and came back with my mother and one child. We used to have family gatherings and everything else, you know what I mean? Everybody you've seen today, you see somebody you don't even know who they are because we've all been split up. And because there was the facilities weren't there that we have today, but they were happy people and we were all happy.
I'm Tosca Agabi Zamaki, and I was born on Russell Street, and I didn't leave it until I got married.
I'm Isotta Garbi Pasqualini. I live in Lynn, Mass, and I haven't seen these people. This is my second time, you know, that he's had this. I hadn't seen them in 48 years. There's people that I didn't see, and it's happy for me.
My name is Teresa Lorenzini Hersey. Go ahead.
I'm Josephine Lorenzini. We were born here in Portsmouth and were brought up in the northern, what we call the northern...
North End.
North End. We were brought up with good Italian people. Most of our friends are here. And we've been getting together every other year. And it's always the same. We don't see each other for a year, and we just love talking to each other. Go ahead.
That's it. Thank you.
You, Jippy, let me do all the talking.
My name is Mary Susie Ciotti. I was born on Russell Street in 1922. My father, when he came from Italy, got a job as a cobbler. My mother used to have a chicken man come to the house every week with live chicken, and all the neighbors would come out, and they would all go out and feel the chicken that they wanted. Then we'd go in the house, kill it, and clean it and dress it and have it for supper. And I also remember the iceman coming to the house. We would have a card in the window telling how much ice we want for the day for our ice boxes, because of course we didn't have refrigerators in those days. All in all, it was Russell Street to me was something special, and I hope my children will always remember it.
Standing there, be part of me. I get a kick, though it's clear to see, yeah, that you obviously, you do not adore me.
My name is Cassetta Canina Gallagher. I lived at 40 Russell Street, and I was born at 35 Russell Street, across the street. When I was 7 years old, my folks moved across the street. We lived there for over 50 years. And my mother came from Italy, and when she came to Portsmouth, she met my father, and they got married. She was only 16 years old. And she went to, Mrs. Prescott took her to learn how to read and write, and took her to the Santa Lucia Club, they called it at the time. And she could speak English and read and write English. And my friends in the area are something that I wish my children would have. I have 5 children, and I hope at least one of them will have as many friends as we have had. I'm 66 years old, and I have the same friends that I've had all my life for 66 years.
My name is Joseph Odorio. I was born and grew up on Russell Street. Well, I remember playing Peggy, Kick the Can, Rolivo, all those games. It was a lot of fun.
My name is Josephine Zockley, and I have 6 sisters. I had one brother. He died when he was 73 years old. My mother and father were here 74 years ago. I miss my little house. It was right in the corner. And I used to enjoy all the people around there. It was just like little Italy.
My name is Kay Pennington. I was born on Market Street. I was the youngest of 6 children, 3 boys and 3 girls. My parents were Rachel and Saverio Francoso, who immigrated from Italy in the early 1900s. One of my fondest memories of the North End was the closeness of my large family, including my aunt and uncle, Fred and Victoria De Stefano, and their 5 children. I remember the happy summers when we would go swimming under the railroad trestle at Nobles Island under the supervision of our older brothers and sisters.
My name is Marty Court, and I was born in 1934 on Deer Street. My mother was Edith Franzoso, who was sister to Catherine Franzoso. This was really a tough neighborhood for those times, but not like today's tough. We had crap games, we had fights, especially with anyone who was outside the Russell Street, Deer Street area. But the kids had respect. Every adult knew you, so you really couldn't get away with a hell of a lot. And if you got away with it at that time, they'd report you back to your parents, and when you get home, you really caught hell. Any adult on Deer Street or Russell Street could chew you out. And at night, we'd swim across from the wharf over to Littlefield's lumber yard, and we'd steal lumber and bring it back in order to build our clubhouses. So like the guy used to say, you know, if the priest would ask him, you know how to make a novena? And we'd say, no, but if you got the plans, we know how to get the lumber.
My name is Jerry Perini. This is my sister, Delmara Allen Perini. Our parents came over from Italy. Our mother is Jane Perini, and our father is the late Tino Perini. We spent a lot of our early years in the North End, growing up there, attending Farragut School, and we have a lot of good memories of that area. And it's really nice to see the people again. We were very disappointed when they did take the North End. It divided an ethnic part of the city, and we were very sorry to see it go.
We question the reason why, especially after seeing all these people here together, why they did this, especially when it was supposed to be for a certain purpose.
My name is Eileen Dondero Foley, and I have with me this evening Captain Capellini, who is the captain of the Italian ship, the Felice Menine, who just came into harbor yesterday morning. And he is a surprise visitor at our beautiful reunion, and we'd like to ask him a few questions. Captain, how do you like our area, and how do you like visiting all our Italian friends?
I can tell you I really like a lot your reception, and that means I like the people and I like the places, because I think that is really a wonderful place.
Thank you.
That is not a compliment, it's the truth.
All right. Many of the women who are here were very happy to meet him because they have relatives back in Milan and in Genoa, and he had a great time talking to them about the area and remembering the old times. Yeah. And my maiden name is Dondero, D-O-N-D-E-R-O, and my grandfather was Joseph Dondero. My grandmother was Carlotta Dondero, and they lived on Russell Street, where this reunion was. They had many children, one of which was my father, Charles Dondero, who was the first Italian boy born in the Russell Street area whose parents both came from Italy. And so he was brought up in that area, and I have a great deal of feeling and love for the people who live there and who have been brought up there, and I just feel because of that that I'm a part of this whole reunion.
My name is Mary Mirasol. My father was Joseph Mirasol and my mother was Rose Mirasol. They came from Sicily. You could sit on your steps on hot summer nights and really stop and talk with each neighbor along the way and reminisce about, they did talk about the old country and things that they remembered from their childhood there, and they were all happy to be here, and they did very well here.
My name is Flo Perini, and I'm a lifelong resident of Russell Street. And Al DiStefano asked me if I wouldn't get in here and talk a little bit about one of the two of the games that we used to play when we were kids. Here I have a paddle and what we call a peggy. A peggy is made of a broom handle sharpened down to 2 points, and the paddle any side of a good box, 3/4-inch stick. And we would have teams, two different teams made up of anything from one person to 20 or 30, whatever we had. And we would hit the peggy, fly in the air, and then hit it with the stick as far as we could. And in return, the other team would have to throw it back towards home plate. Now, home plate we would have as a manhole cover in our neighborhood, and we'd start off there. I'd just like to reiterate on one particular game, the generation before me were playing on a Sunday afternoon, and we started off at Wall Street at the top of the hill, and from there they worked their way all the way down to Market Street and all the way up into Market Square, where everybody is familiar with the officer. We used to have Joe Kelly. Even though we didn't have much traffic in them days, he stopped traffic so we could play through. And we played through until they got right behind the North Church. Then the other team would take the peggy, and each person on that team would have to throw that peggy back towards home plate, and they would get 2 turns apiece. And that would take up probably one whole afternoon just to play that one game. Another thing we had was, we used to call our elastic guns. It's made out of inner tube and just 2 pieces of wood. And we would play cowboys and Indians with it. And you'd load it in through here and pull it down on the end so that when you let up on it, it would fly off and hit the individual, and he would supposedly be dead. And there were several other games we used to play with jackknives, baseball games on the board, flipping the knife. And we used to have a lot of enjoyment and games that we'll never forget that the children don't play today, because they really don't have the room for it like we did. Thank you.
Someone came up to me and said, young man, take a walk up the street. It's a place there. Call the YMCA. They can start you back on your way. It's fun to stay in the
I'm living a plot of earth, a street, the grocer and the butcher, and the people that I meet. Children in the playground, the faces that I see, all races and religions. That's America to me. The place I work in, the worker by my side, the little town, the city where my people.
I really miss Russell Street. I'm so sorry they tore all those houses down. It was a beautiful place to grow up. I wish my daughters had had it.
And the right to speak your mind out. That's America to me.